Hi, everybody, and welcome to today's showcase, the Theater of Arts Graduating Showcase. My name is Alex Feldman, and I've had the unique privilege of directing today's showcase. We appreciate you joining us this Thursday evening, and we know how busy everybody is, so we kept the program today quite short, about 15 minutes. But during those 15 minutes, you will see the four graduates and their ability to perform. These graduates are all very unique and multi-talented. They've just completed a vigorous training of a two-year conservatory program at Theater of Arts. They are capable and ready to work. And for that, I'd like to take a moment to thank the entire faculty of Theater of Arts. And especially, I'd like to throw out a quick thank you to our demo reel instructor, Mateusz Szymanski. He provided the last scene you will see in today's showcase. This entire showcase was shot and produced under strict COVID restrictions following the same regulations as the Screen Actors Guild. For that reason, these actors had to shoot some of the scenes themselves, which is quite a comment on their abilities. This showcase also includes a lot of the written material that was written by the showcase participants themselves as well. Without further ado, please enjoy our showcase and stick around afterwards because our Director of Education, David Law, will introduce the showcase participants who will come on live and you'll get to meet them. Thank you for joining us and enjoy the show.
Make you a star, Chris. You got the accent going. You gotta commit to it. You gotta go in full throttle. You're gonna get it.
So these two guys are kicking the shit out of each other, right? This guy picks up an old kitchen sink that someone threw out and crushes this guy with it. This guy's fucking hamburger, man. His spine's crushed. He's all twisted and shit. That had to be one big motherfucker. Huge. Or okay, check this out. Say these two don't even know the fucking huge guy. You know, they're just staggering home from the bar this morning, still fucked up from St. Patty's last night. So they decided they could take a shortcut down through the alley. And this big motherfucker, he's just waiting, right? And what could be more perfect for a strong-armed robbery? Two drunk guys all bandaged up. They're already injured, for Christ's sake. And so he comes over, picks up a kitchen sink, and he crushes this poor motherfucker. Jumps on this guy's back, crushes him to death, steals their shit, and beats it. And look at that shoe, man. Look at that footprint. That's one big fucking shoe. I don't know. I feel something big here. You know, I wouldn't be surprised if we see more of these turning up. Can we stop? I'm like...
What's the matter? What's going on?
Where did you get this? Where'd you get this script? What am I reading?
What do you mean where I found it? I found it on the internet. I found it where every other actor is.
You know me. The Westerns, man. When are we going to start doing some Westerns? That's my thing.
I got you the Westerns. I'm just waiting on it. That's it. It's 2021, okay? It's 2021. I cannot force everybody to work. Chris, I'm working on it.
You know what? I can't do this. I can't do this.
Yes, you can. Don't say that. Yes, you can. Come on.
I don't want to hear.
It's nice.
Rocky, it's nice.
Forget.
And you remember.
I don't know.
What's to know? How it is today, that's how it is.
But the boat is moving.
So it's colder in relation to how fast the boat is moving.
So it's colder in the water than on the land.
So it's colder in relation to the water.
So it's a different temperature on the boat than on the bench.
Ducks.
Where?
Well, I'm pointing. Sure sign of spring.
Autumn, too.
Uh-huh. There they go.
There they go.
Same when it's warm.
They come back.
They got a leader. or lead duck. He starts, well, he's a duck, but he stays with the pack. So many times, he comes, he goes, he learns the route. Maybe he's got a little more hell to go.
It's boring just to think about that.
This is it.
Home sweet home.
Hey man, that was a good run today, man. Like, a good run. You should take some of that money you made and buy some new clothes.
Hey man, these clothes are classics.
Mm-hmm. Hey man, you gotta find one.
Keep your hands off me. What's
the matter with you? Yeah, she was fine. As long as I don't touch her.
Hey, you touch her, and I'll kick your ass.
Licky, licky, licky. It's all starting to become clear. How is it?
Good.
You know, you're a real cool customer on the court, man. Real chill like that on the streets. You can't be rattled in your cage. Nah. You don't even let all that nigga shit on the court fuck with you, but when it comes to your woman, let's see. That's a whole different matter altogether. Look at you, man. Ain't you talk trash. Ain't even push up on the sister. You already think about it.
Shut the fuck up.
No. It's getting to know. It's real good to know. Now, Billy, I am your weakness. Billy, you just like every other white boy I've ever met, man.
You're just like every other brother I knew on the playground.
All right. Kick some shit, baby.
You'd rather look good and lose than look bad and win.
All right, because you don't know shit about me.
I know plenty about you, Sydney. How many meals that changed in your family
hey.
Back?
You know what? Why don't you go get some rest, Brady Bunch? You're going to need it.
I ain't tired.
Word. Okay. Hey, Gloria. Yo, it was really nice seeing you again, all right? Yeah. Take care, all right? You know what? I really dig those drinks of yours. Yeah.
Kind of fly.
Yeah, for real, I really dig it. Yeah, all right. You take care, okay? Hey, Billy, I need you to get your rest, man. Tomorrow we're going to 103rd Street. Don't hustle out there. It's Watts. It's tough game, so it's big bucks.
Man, take it personal. Your teammates, it's Ebony and Ivy, baby.
Yeah, I got you fucked.
All right, fuck me, right? I know one thing, don't get caught crossing the bridge before sundown.
Oh, Mr. Officer, please help the Negro go get you.
It's boring just to think about that.
Duck's life, hidden all hearts and flowers. He's got his worries too. He's got fleas and lice, disease in the body, wing problems, sexual difficulties, many things.
It's not an easy life.
Small vicious children.
Chain stores. Of course, with blue hair.
Aaron.
The hereditary enemy of the duck. The duck's part of the bargain.
It's to be eaten by the blue heron.
But it's to... Well, it slips me up. But it's not as one-sided as it might appear. Nature's given the duck speed and endurance in the art of concealment. She's made the heron large and unwieldy and blue to be spotted at a distance.
What about the size of the bird? Shaped like a bird?
Not necessary.
No.
What we do know that as long as the duck exists, you'll fight day and night, well and sick with the harem. As long as the sky becomes dark with the wing of the monster bird, the harem will feast on duck.
We gotta go already.
Why? You forgot the formula. Why are you always late to everything?
It's not my fault you want to go to your sister's house so you can get drunk.
I promised that boy. I asked you if you wanted to go, but instead you said you wanted to spend some time with the family.
Yes, some time, not the whole damn night. Plus, I told you not to get drunk with your sister.
Ay, ¿sabes qué? Me tienes harta de tus pendejadas.
Pendejadas tuyas, me tienes como perro para aquí, para allá, para aquí, para allá, para aquí, para allá.
Ay,
no manches.
She's calling me.
Oh, answer it.
No, I'm gonna hang up with them. You're so stupid. Hello?
Hi, mamacita, ¿cómo estás? Yeah, how'd you sleep?
Better than us, that's for sure.
Huh? Yeah. No, me and Santiago are totally ready. Yes, I promise you we're not missing Junior's birthday party. Okay. Yeah. Listo. Okay, we'll see you soon. Okay, dale pues. Besitos, bye.
No te pongas peda, okay? That's all I'm saying. Don't get drunk out, alright?
Do whatever I want! Move
it! You got all the bags, right?
Yup.
Oh, okay. Oh my god, I'm so hungry. What are they serving again?
I think they got tacos.
Really?
Yup. And they got menudo, taquitos, chilaquiles, burritos, pozole de verde, rojo, agua frescas, and pizza.
Okay, let's go.
Vámonos, we're gonna eat like gringos. Oh my god, yes.
What's the pizza for?
Oh, the pizza's for the kids.
The kids!
Ducks? Canadian ducks? Had a panda at the other zoo, but it died.
Tortured anyone before. I didn't expect it to be so.
Mike, you need to let this shit go. Right? None of this is in the job description.
Fuck is so fun. You must think I'm a real fucking psychopath. How long have we known each other?
Long enough for me to know that you wouldn't do this just for fun.
That's right. I'm gonna get her back.
Why? This isn't you. The Mike I know wouldn't risk his career, let alone his life, over some Instagram and daddy's girl.
Shut the fuck up! She wasn't like that.
Bullshit. Alright, they're all like that, man. Every last one of them. Alright, we protect them and we don't get involved, Mike. It's a job.
She wasn't a job.
You too? Fucking Jesus, Mike.
I'm all she's got. Who else can I trust? I love her, Sean. I need to do this.
All right, fine. Let's go.
What? No, no, you said it yourself. It's not your problem.
You're my problem.
Well, 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 thanks for watching, but maybe not listening by the looks of it in the chat. So I hope you can hear me now. I should say that we were a theatre school that was formed at the end of the silent era, so we thought we'd keep that going. So sorry about that. It's something to do with Zoom. We're looking into it. We'll replay it again straight away after this Q&A, which we'll keep very short, and we'll make it all available to everybody tomorrow. In the meantime, let's look at the silent heroes. I heard it perfectly, and I know half of you did, and half of you didn't for some reason. Who knows? Anyway, let me introduce you to the heroes of the hour, Chris Granlund. Hopefully he can hear me now. Great, yeah. Excellent. Kat Benitez is our femme fatale there. And we've got Lyrik Johnson and Juan de la Rosa. Come and say hello. Thank you, guys. Well done. Congratulations on graduating Theatre of Arts. And I thought it sounded great. It was a wonderful showcase. I don't know if you heard it. Did you hear it, Chris?
Yeah, I could hear it. I could hear it just fine. I was just watching everybody have an internal breakdown.
I could see that. I could see my
friend. It looked really good.
Yeah, it looked. So
it looked amazing. It looked really good.
So you couldn't hear it, Lyrik? Is that what you're saying?
No, I was playing my own internal audio along with what was going
on. Well, at least you could do that. And what about you, Juan? Could you hear it?
No, I unfortunately couldn't hear it. But it's all right, though. It's all cool.
It looked great. You were getting lots of compliments in the chat about how good it looked. And those who can hear it, it did sound good as well, but we'll work on that. I just want to talk to you guys just for a couple of minutes to introduce you. Chris, tell us about yourself before you were an actor. What were you doing before you were an actor?
Before I was an actor, I lived in Northern California in a city called Pleasanton. After high school, I didn't really do a whole lot of acting in high school, but I joined the military and I went into the Marine Corps and I got stationed in 29 Palms and I deployed to Southeast Asia twice, spending time in Okinawa, Japan, Thailand, and South Korea. And then when I got back, I went to college, thankfully with the GI Bill, and went to a community college in my hometown, and I started out with theater, and that's where I got my start, and that's where my first love is with theater. And after I graduated from the community college, I moved down to LA and to pursue a career, which I regrettably didn't prepare was going to be as hard as I thought it was going to be. But thankfully I found TOA and I still had some GI Bill under my belt and I was able to, really reestablish who I was and what my goals were.
Great. Thanks, Chris. I believe we've got somebody else, who was in the military. Lyrik, you were also in the military, but you're also a musician, correct?
Yes, sir. I was, I did the military from 2001 to 2008. And then I got out of the military, did some traveling, and I moved out here in Los Angeles in 2016 and did two programs at Musicians Institute, and I stumbled into TOA.
Well, we're glad you did.
Me too.
We're glad you did. People are just texting me all the way through this, just with things like, can't hear, I'll go, yeah, all right, I'll come back to you people. But I'm glad that you came to TOA and you had a great 2 years here. Kat, tell us about yourself. What's your background?
Well, I am from Miami, but my family's from Colombia. So I'm a super, super proud Latina. I'm a family person. I have three boys, three beautiful boys. And like the other gentleman, I moved to here to pursue acting. And I graduated from TOA. And yeah, I'm just here ready to have fun with my boys, my family, and, you know, rock this town.
Thank you, Kat. You're certainly rocking it. All right, Juan de la Rosa, who, you know, he's a recent graduate, but has done pretty well. Tell us about yourself, Juan, and what the kind of things that you've been doing. Like, doing the odd little movie here and there.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of auditioning here and there. You know, just trying to get myself on the feet during these hard times as a mist. Mm-hmm. So, you know, just going little by little. And, you know, just, it's not really work. It's more like creating and having fun for me. So, you know, the more when I can create, the more I can have fun. I have done a Nickelodeon gig, you know, a couple lines here and there, but you know what? It was my first gig. And from there, I just knew that this is where I needed to do. And this is what I, you know, want to do. And
were you in a movie with Vince Vaughn recently? Are you gonna try and shy away from that?
Yeah, I mean, I did. I'm not gonna say out the name just because of reasons, but yes, I did come out in another little part here and there, and I just got heard that I booked something else as well, but I can't talk about it either.
Wow, this is the modern actor for you. It's the NDAs, isn't it? They basically said, I've done loads of stuff. I just can't tell you about any of it. Well, thanks for joining. Thanks for sticking with us. You know, we're going to get you the recording so that you can actually hear it. But congratulations again to Lyric, to Chris, to Juan, and to Kat. I think it was great. Great. And, you know, thanks for joining us. And I'm so, so sorry if you couldn't hear it. I know that half of you couldn't. We don't know why half of you could. But look, have a lovely evening and we'll send you the copy. All right. Thank you. Good night.
Good night.